Hello, my name is Kenneth Eagleton. I'm director of field partnerships for IM. And today we're going to talk a little bit about the partnership that we have in Cuba. IM sent missionaries to Cuba in 1940, and we had missionaries there during the 40s and the 50s until the revolution in Cuba, after which we were not able to maintain missionaries there anymore. But several churches had already been planted and leadership training had been done. And so we see that the work has continued in spite of the fact that there were not resident missionaries in the country. Today, there are approximately 145 churches that are part of our Association of Free Will Baptist Churches there. Most of these are house churches. This is the way that most of them have to operate there as house churches. And on any given week, we have approximately 6,000 people that worship in these house churches and some in church buildings, the few church buildings that exist there. We continue at IM, we continue to have a relationship with the Association of Churches there through a partnership. We have a written agreement with them. There are several projects that we cooperate on. And that's what I wanted to share with you today, some of these projects. One of them that we're very happy to be a part of is the training of leaders there in Cuba. Currently, they have a 268 people that are in training at different levels. There are 8 Bible institutes that function in different areas of Cuba. We also have a seminary that has several different programs that they offer. They offer a one-year program which does some training for church planters. And then they have a three-year undergraduate program. When they come out with a BA in ministry and Bible. And then in that program, they have it on campus as well as in some extensions in different churches as well. Then they also have a master's program. I think they have approximately 10 people now in the master's program. So we do cooperate with them on helping them to maintain this training. We have sent several teachers down to Cuba besides the financial help in maintaining the training going. We also have a project with them with the Association of Churches in the area of church planting. They are doing all that they can to plant churches in all 15 provinces of Cuba. And I think there's just one or two provinces that they still where we still do not have Free Will Baptist churches. But at any given time, we have between 20 and 25 church planters that are being supported in some degree or another by the National Association, and our cooperation with them helps in supporting these church planters in different provinces across Cuba. Another project that we have is we help them in sponsoring, partially sponsoring, many camps and retreats that they organize throughout the year for different age groups. They have retreats for the handicapped, they have retreats for and camps for the youth and for the adolescents, for children, for couples. There is a pastor's retreat as well during the year. So they have an extensive program of camps and retreats that we help them with as well. Another thing that is very exciting is to see how that many in Cuba have answered the call to cross-cultural ministry. Cuba, who once was a receiving country for missionaries, is now actually sending out missionaries to other countries. Currently, they have a couple that is in Uruguay, ministering in Uruguay. They are revitalizing a church there in Uruguay. They also have a couple and a single lady who are in Ivory Coast, working with our medical work there in Ivory Coast, and also One of them is a church planter, and he is helping with the church there in Ivory Coast. So these five missionaries, we do help them in supporting, partially supporting these missionaries. We also have the partnership from the state of Alabama that helps in supporting the missionaries from Cuba that are currently in Uruguay. So we are helping them set up this program. That's still something that they are working on and setting up their cross-cultural missionary program. Then another area that, another project that we have is helping out with the nursing home that the association has in Havana. There is a nursing home there that is full. It's in fact beyond capacity. I think there are 30 something people, residents there, and they could put twice as many people there if they just had the room. So we are helping them find the funds for expanding their capacity there. Foundation, Free Will Baptist Foundation, gave a grant also towards that. So we are working in helping the nursing home there in Havana to be able to care for the aged there in Cuba. There are several other smaller projects that we're working on, but this will give you an idea of the things that are involved. There is a lot of important ministry going on. It is facilitating the church there in Cuba to reach more of the island. And your giving to the World Mission Offering, to WMO, will help support all of these different projects, because the main source of funding for our partnerships and in as well as this partnership that we have in Cuba, comes from the World Mission Offering. So we hope that you will participate in supporting the WMO during the month of April so that these ministries can continue and, as the Lord allows, even to expand. Thank you very much.